Everyone, again you can watch me make 4 resin geode coasters, and I don't know if you saw my previous video, but in that video I made the first 4 geode coasters of a commission of 8 coasters, and so I will use the same colors as I did in that video. I'm going to use black, white, gray and silver. So I will add the link to that video for of the first 4 coasters in the right corner, so you can watch it. And I hope you will enjoy my video and give me a thumbs up for it. So I already started with pouring some clear resin onto the edge of the coaster mold. And I'm using the silicone mold from Molds and Shapes. They have great quality silicone mold. So if you are interested, the link to their website is in the description box below this video. I also have a promo code. If you use my code JustPaint5, then you will get 5% discount on your total value order. So that's great. So I hope I can create some different effects. So that's why I'm doing it a little bit different. Now I'm adding the lines, and I'm starting with white, the Casting Craft white, adding the lines out of a Ziploc bag. Yeah, I call it a Ziploc bag, but I think you can also call it a Piper bag, or I don't know, but you can. These bags are also used for cake decoration. So I'm adding very thin lines on top of the clear resin, so not on the silicon, but into the clear resin. There you can see it, very thin line, and hopefully I can create some different effects than my first 4 coasters. But yeah, I need to use these colors because the client loves these colors. And I think they are also going very well together. I hope you don't hear my friend's bulldog. He's so loud. But yeah, I can't tell him to not make noise. Adding a little bit more of the white. Now you can see it. And the next color is one of my mica pigments. It's the Sparkle White. Because, as you all know, I love sparkle. And my client also loves sparkle. So that's why I chose the Sparkle White. So next to the white, also on top of the clear resin, a line of this Sparkle White. On to the last coaster. So I am trying to go from light on the outside to dark in the middle. So this is a nice silver color, and it's a mica pigment, one of my mica pigments. It's the Twinkling Silver Star. The same sparkle as the Sparkle White, but then in a silver color. Also on top of the clear resin. So not on the silicone, but on top of the clear resin. And I'm doing this because then the colors can flow much better into each other. And if I pour the line on top of the silicone, then the color will stay on that place, because it's then stuck on your silicone mold. And this is a color from Just Resin. It's the Platinum a darker shade next to the twinkling silver star. And what I mentioned, I'm going from light to dark. So I've started with white, then the sparkle white, then I've used a silver, the twinkling silver star, and now I'm using the platinum. And this is a paste. So I'm also using paste and mica pigments together to see what kind of effects I can create. Adding a little bit more of the clear resin, because otherwise I can't add another line, and I want to add another shade next to the platinum. So that's why I'm adding a little bit more of the clear resin. And the last color that I'm using is the Blackbird. It's one of my mica pigments. Very nice. And hopefully both sides are pretty, so that they can be used on both sides. So in this video I will show you the whole process of pouring into the silicone mold, adding a clear layer of resin. I'm going to show you how I do that on one side, but also going to show you how I finish the edges. And then of course I'll show you the end result. So all the supplies I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the link to the website. And if you're interested in my mica pigments or silicone druzy inlay molds or chameleon mica pens and a lot more supplies, the link to my Etsy shop is below this video in the description. And they are also available in the USA and Canada by my associate Evelyn Schaefer. The link to her Etsy shop is also below this video in the description. And next to the black, I'm adding again a white line. And the resin I'm using, as I always do, is the resin from Resin Pro. It's the Art Pro resin, a medium viscosity resin, heat resistant up to 100 degrees. So that's good enough for a hot cup of coffee or tea. But normally I would add a heat resistant layer because they have a special resin for that. But at the moment they are working on a better resin, and so it's not available. But hopefully soon it will be available, and then I have a heat resistant up to 250 degrees, so that is very good. But 100 degrees is also good enough. Now I'm filling the total layer with clear. There you can see it pushing those colors to the outside. And normally those colors will flow back to the center, and then you can create very nice effects. Using my embossing tool to remove some air bubbles. I never use a torch because then you have a risk that your resin will stick to the silicone mold, and that's not good because then you can damage your silicone mold. In the middle, adding some nice silver leaf, there you can see it. I also used this silver leaf in the other four coasters. also a mixture of glass glitter and normal glitter in the color silver. Very nice, very sparkly. And this glitter will not flow in your resin because the glass glitter is heavy, and it will stay where I add it. A little bit more of the silver leaf. So I will let this dry, and then I will go to the next step. And that is to take them out of the silicone mold. Yeah, this is 1 hour later, and I really wanted to show you the effects that I already have. It looks very pretty on this side. It looks a little bit like a flower, because I call this technique the flower technique. Very nice. So I'm very pleased with this side of the coasters, and hopefully the other side is also nice. There you can see the effects. Very sparkly center. So the resin is dry, and now it's time to take the coasters out of the mold. And I never have any problems with that. They come out very easy. They are transparent in the center, very nice. So now we can take a closer look. This side is very pretty. So hopefully the other side is also nice. They are transparent in the center, there you can see it. That's a totally different effect, much more black. Also nice, great depth. Yeah, I'm happy. So in this part of the video, I'm going to show you how I finish the edges. I already did the two on the right side, so now I'm going to show you how I add my color. And I'm using a Molotow liquid chrome marker, very nice silver color, very shiny. There you can see it. And after this, I need to add a clear layer of resin because I need to protect that silver line. So I'm going to do this on both sides because they can be used on both sides. So also the link to this marker you can find in the description box below this video. So this is the other side. Again, I already did the two on the right, and now I'm going to add a line on the other two. At the end of this video, I will show you all a close-up. Then you can see the colors much better, but also this silver line. But it's very easy to apply. Yeah, and it doesn't have to be perfect. It can be a little bit thicker line or a thinner line. Doesn't matter. Yeah, for me it doesn't matter. Maybe for you it does, but for me, I like it when it's not that perfect. So the silver line is dry, and now I can add a clear layer of resin. I always start in the middle, then I use my heat gun to remove some air bubbles, but also to make the resin a little bit more liquid, and then I work my way to the outside. And this time I will not let it flow over the sides, I only push it to the edge, and hopefully I will get that nice doming effect. The other side I already done, and now I'm going to show you this side, how I add that clear layer of resin. There you can see it, I'm using my steering stick, and I speeded this part of the video, but normally it will takes much longer because you need to be very careful that you don't push the resin over the sides. Yeah, and I already got some feedback from my client because I sent some pictures and they love the coasters, so that's great to hear. And I want to take some time to thank my monthly sponsors. I want to thank Evelyn for being such a good friend, but also sending me so nice supplies. And I want to thank Andrea for all your support and your donation. I appreciate it a lot, so thank you so much. And of course I want to thank Elijah and Resin Pro for sending me such nice good quality supplies. So thank you so much, everyone. So this is the end result, and this is the side how I poured it. I love this side very much. Very pretty. So sorry for the reflection of the light, but yeah, I have them outside in the daylight. Then I'm trying to show you a little bit more by getting closer. It sparkles a lot, so I'm very pleased how this side looks. Now the other side, also nice, very nice sparkle in it, but also great depth. So if you like what I'm doing, consider to subscribe. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up for this video. All the information to the supplies I've used you can find in the description box. Also my promo codes and the link to my own Facebook page. So come on and join me. And I want to thank you all for watching again. And hopefully I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.